people in general, unless they're very technically inclined, don't really realize what is going on behind the scenes. They expect from a combat fighter that there is a lot of computer control going in behind, but I don't think they expect that there is so much going on in a car or in a toaster. My name is Rudolf Seethaler. I'm an associate professor at the School of Engineering and in the program of mechanical engineering. My focus of research is motion control, and motion control is found in many different applications. At the miniature, minute scale, you can look at microscopes. When they focus their lenses, then they have to move them for a few micrometers. At the larger scale, engine valves that need to be placed within a centimeter distance at very high speeds. And at the largest scale or larger scale, you can look at factory automation, where big robots pick up parts and place them several meters away in different locations. Before I came to UBC Okanagan, I was working for BMW in their research center in Munich in Germany, and one of the more interesting projects that I was working on back then was the control of engine valves. Engine valves are typically controlled with CAM systems, and we tried to control them with electromagnetic actuators. This technology has several advantages. It reduces emissions and it improves fuel economy. It is able to do that with less after treatment, which in the future could make this technology more attractive. High-speed motion control is fascinating because when you look at a system that needs to be moved very, very quickly, then you can't just take an actuator off the shelf and put it together. You have to design all of the different components at the same time to make them work really well. And that means you design your electrical system, you design your mechanical system, you design your magnetic system all at the same time, and it turns into a very challenging but interesting project. I'm actually interested in two different engine applications mainly. One of them is the control of the intake and exhaust valves, which is the topic I've taken over from after I came from BMW. The other application is dealing with fuel injectors, where we have much smaller motions but much faster motion. This is an example that I'm studying together with a company in Vancouver that specializes in natural gas fuel injection. And I'm also interested outside the automotive field in the improvement of performance of machine tools. And in that case, it's not just motion control that I'm interested in. I'm also interested in integrating all kinds of sensory information that would make it more efficient to produce parts. Advances in motion control in the automotive sector will basically lead to the replacement of many of the traditionally hydraulic systems into electromagnetic systems. You've seen that. Nowadays you can buy power steering components that are electromagnetically driven instead of hydraulically driven. The next step that you're going to be seeing is probably braking systems that are electromagnetic. And when we reach this point where engines are improved using my high-speed electromagnetic valves and fuel injectors, you will see large improvements in fuel economy and in a reduction in emissions.